Have you ever faced a situation where things were working 5 years back, all of a sudden you realize that the same idea, the same concept is not at all working at present? If you have already faced it, then I am 100% sure you are leading an organization, you are a visionary. In fact, let me tell you, change is such a difficult thing for most of the people in their life to handle, because it happens many times that in a career, let's say imagine you're on a ladder. I was reading this book, Ladder Shift by Samuel R. Chand, and he talks about that when a leader moves on a ladder, all of a sudden he will see that the plinth is gone. The ladder is shifted, and once the surface is shifted, now you have to come back, it means you've forgotten your path. Now what do you do? Well, that is the extreme, but that is how today the world is existing, because everything is changing at a rapid pace. And this is a series where I'm trying to cover the challenges of a change. So I'll tell you three major challenges of a change to begin with. First point, that very few people like change. Let me stop some time here and explain you. Initially, I used to assume when I was new to leadership role and very new to mentorship and coaching, I used to assume that leaders are a group of people who like changes. But then I was really shocked and surprised that leaders also are resistant to the change. The only time a leader accepts the change is when the idea is his or her own idea. It means when it is your baby, you are willing to change. But when the idea is coming from somewhere else, you are not willing to change. I was surprised. Second thing which I came to realize was this. Most people do not know how to change. The first challenge is very few people like the change. Second challenge is most people do not know how to change. What does that mean? Change means certain things are changing at a rapid pace. Now, if it is a new thing, do you think we will know how to change? That means it is an unknown territory. And when it is an unknown territory, we do not know what is the right way to start, what is the right thing to do. Under this condition, again, it becomes a challenge. So, second crisis is most people do not know how to change. The third one is some people know only that change is essential for growth. So what I have covered till now, I covered the first point is that most people do not want to change, including leaders. Second point I covered was that very few people know how to change in the right manner. The third point which I am trying to cover right now is this, that very few people are aware that change is essential for their growth. In fact, there is a classical book of John Maxwell which was released some 9 months back, Leader Shift, in which John categorically mentions that in 80s, the long-term plan used to be of 20 years. Short-term plan used to be of 5 years. Today, when you're talking about the long-term plans are of 2 years and short-term plans are less than 6 months. It means whatever we are learning is changing at such a rapid pace that if somebody is not aware that change is essential for their growth, they will be outdated too early. So that's what I wanted to cover today. So I'll summarize. Today I covered three essential things why it is a challenge to change is, first, very few people like change. Second, most people are not aware how to change in the right manner. Third, most people are not even aware that change is essential for the growth.